Tornado Energy 7-2 over Ding in the final, and that will mean that Tornado Energy are the winners of the World of Tanks 2017 Grand Finals.
Tornado, they deserve this. They have worked an entire year towards this moment, and once more, they have shown everybody what kind of a dominant team they are. They've had the hardest road throughout this tournament, beating the likes of NSS, beating the likes of Na'Vi as well. Everything they got, they deserve. They deserve to be in this final, and they deserve to be the Grand Champion as well.
They certainly did look like the best team throughout this tournament. They have looked very, very strong throughout the past year as well. This competition, it's been tough for Ding, but they have to hold their hands and hold their heads high as well after that one. But really, it is today the day of Tornado Energy.
Yeah, you can hear on the other side, the Russian commentator is very happy about this one. Obviously, we would have liked to see Ding win it, right? But Tornado just show what a masterclass team they are on every map. They just, it's not even tactics, it's just the individual skill coming out from these players, not just as individuals, but as a unit as well. The way they play together, it's just so good, it's so on point, and you just make it work no matter what position they're in.
Fitting as well that it is Apple WoW to close that one out for Tornado Energy. But once again, congratulations to Tornado Energy. They had the most difficult run through to the final there as well, and they were able to close it out. So you've heard from us. Now I think it's time to hand it back over to our analysts and hear from them.
Thanks very much there, Elfish Guy. As you were just saying there yourself, what a fitting end to the tournament. Apowo last season, heartbreak on Cliff when he got himself stuck. It cost his team the grand finals. This time round, he is vindicated. He wins the final round for his team. He takes home the trophy.
I would say the karma definitely spins some wheels here. I mean, how coincidental is it that AppleWOW, of all the players there, is left one-on-one to decide the round on Cliff no more. I noticed one thing on these tactics here. They attacked everywhere except the hill where he got stuck last time.
They were avoiding it like wildfire, but here's the thing as well.
That part doesn't exist.
Right below the area as well, right below his hill. Unbelievable, wasn't it, Rockstar?
Yeah, definitely. The one round that really sticks out to me was the first round on Prokhorovka, where Tornado just said, we are going to show you how dominant we are. We don't care. We know we're up. We are going to go straight up and over into you. They took the brawl, and they won it decisively. There was no hesitating. There was no sitting around missing shots. They said, we know we are the better team. And they just went for it, and they took that round handily. And from then on, it was smooth sailing.
I'll be 100% honest. I was screaming through that game for Ding to come back into it. It's like, Mojo, they can do this. They can just get through Cliff. It's going to happen. But
I really thought that Break actually has it. I thought he needs to just hug the wall and wait for AppleWOW to come down and clip him because TVP shoots so fast. But evidently he missed some shots. What can you do? Even happens even to the best.
And he was playing so great as well for Ding. I mean, everyone in Ding, let's take nothing away from what Ding have accomplished here. Getting through to the grand finals. Halkenick said that at the season finals, this is what we want to do. Now look at this, coming up on stage right now, it is our season champions coming out first. There is Tornado Energy. The other teams out on stage, so we're going to bring out all 12 teams, I believe, who have participated in this tournament. It has been absolutely fantastic. A lot of teams came here with, you know, something to show that they are, you know, not just a flash in the pan. And I think we've definitely seen that this tournament, haven't we, gentlemen?
They're boys from NSS. This was a week-long event. Teams best from the world, what we have gathered up here. We saw a lot of new things, how this patch works. It will give a lot of ideas to players how to play. They can take this as a role model and think on what will be the next.
And then you guys keep saying how this is just a week-long event. This has been a year-long event for most of these guys. Multiple seasons, hours of practice, all leading down to this. And once again, congrats to Tornado Energy. A very fitting end.
Some of them definitely look like they need to sleep.
Yep, we see Team Efficiency on stage. Now we're looking at Eclipse, the second American team on stage. Master People there with these arms still bandaged. Teams are filling out us. I mean, I don't even know if we have enough space on stage now.
I think they're going to squeeze.
It looks like perhaps as Elevate coming out next, I think. Can't really see from this distant view. Short sleeve, dark tops.
That does look like an American name, but this is Brainstorm.
Oh, it's Brainstorm, of course, yes.
And this is their manager, Trix.
Wasn't actually sure of the Brainstorm team logo. They were looking at Oops, the Tough Giraffes right now, going back to Eclipse. They've been up in their room watching it. You can see, you know, Dark God Sim there in the middle. They're going back. NSS coming across here as well. Elevate in front of them. Ding, see? Sheesh at the end there. I mean, dang, those guys, you can look at the draining on their face. Look at Breakneck's face. That's so heartbreaking.
Oh, dude. He's going to be okay tomorrow and willing to play. You know how it goes. Well, these guys are really happy, and he did look like he had a lot of fun on this tournament, man, no matter what happened.
And what a hell of a season they've had. We were talking about it earlier on, weren't we, Rockstar? What a hell of a season Tornado Energy have been, so dominant against everyone they've played here.
Yep, they struggled a little bit during the last Russian season, but they showed up to their season finals. They won that. They show up here. They don't miss a beat the whole time. Na'Vi slipped up. They sensed the weakness. They took capitalize on it. Played Ding here in the finals, and they made it look easier than it should have.
Yes, it's real interesting. We have Mo Fado, head of competitive gaming at here with Wargaming. He's going to present the MVP trophy award. It goes to Breakneck here from Ding. So Europe does get to take something home there. We had the best
plate. Well, the shiny plate is ours, and we are not giving it away.
Yes, we're going to keep that. We're going to take hold of it. I'm sure Breakneck will be extremely happy with that, but sadly, it just wasn't enough. But hey,
I'm sure he would gladly trade 10 of those for one of those big ones in the middle.
Yeah, indeed, indeed. Now you can see Tornado Energy eyeing up that trophy. You look at Niru staring at it, locked in.
You're mine. Well, he definitely deserved it. Man, this is the second one for him.
Yeah, I mean, it's again, and it just stays between these two teams, Tornado and Na'Vi. They pretty much just rotate. I wonder if they have an agreement. Okay, boys, you can have it next year, you know?
Yeah, well, after last year, you have to wonder, because what a game that was.
Yeah.
And, you know, going forward, we'll have to keep an eye on Na'Vi as well, see what they do during the offseason. Going forward, maybe some changes have to come in there.
Okay, now to award the winners' medals, we have Thane and, well, Anton Pankov, Thane Lyman. Anton Pankov, known to many people as Evilly, executive publishing producer for World of Tanks, presenting the, looks like the medals for the various teams. Well, we're going to go through every single team. So Elevate currently getting their medals right now.
Picking
Thane
up.
Lyman, World of Tanks product director, was speaking to him earlier on, you know, interesting talk from him.
A lot of fun stuff in the works for World of Tanks. It's not over here.
New maps coming as well. I mean, they look really interesting.
Ranked battles, a lot of exciting stuff still coming.
And the thing is about the new maps is they get complete overhaul for the terrain as well. So various places you can go to, can't get to, going to be totally different. Open up the maps and new avenues.
Yeah, well, we'll have to see what happens to the boost, though, because we may lose a lot of those. But just the same, it's going to change the meta and a lot of options for these teams in the league going forward.
Now, this Oxmanthus walking away. He was an exceptional player for Elevate, wasn't he?
Definitely. He's one of their top damage dealers all season long, and he played out of his mind through this tournament, especially in the group stages. He had some games, even where his team was losing. I recall one game, he did over 5,000 damage on a loss. Just such a fantastic player, very instinctual. Just unfortunate that they couldn't get past the semifinal.
Canadian Impact, last one to get the medal there on the unfortunate end of a RAM incident from an E50M there on Himmelsdorf. And Elevate put up a hell of a fight during this tournament. Up next, NSS. I mean, we had them potentially tipped for greatness, but in the end, it just proved, I mean, it was, at the end, they can always say we got put out by the champions, can't they?
Yep, but they finished higher than Na'Vi did. They're going to take home third, fourth place, tied with Elevate. So I don't think they'll be too disappointed. Obviously, everyone wants to take first, but in this case, I think they'll be happy with what they accomplished.
Mojo, your thoughts on Not So Serious this tournament?
Well, you get what you deserve and you keep what you win. They came that far and they deserved it by far. But they definitely met an, I would say, unmovable object. That would be Tornado.
I mean, how, looking at this from like an objective point of view, looking at this
more
from
like unstoppable, actually.
How do you do that? What in your opinion, what do you think would work against Tornado to try and, you know, It's trying to get advantage on them, trying to get ahead of them, hold time. The advantage.
This is their time. They are young enough, they are eager enough, they are skillful enough, they invested enough time. All of those components are there here gathered in one team that can play so explosive with minimum requirements of tactics. Yes, they read the map perfect. They have initial tactics, but most of it relies how will they cooperate with each other. That's the basis of it, and this is the best tanks you can imagine.
And what it comes down to is it's not just the fact that there's no one thing that's going to make another team come and take them over. They do so many things well. Their tactics, their individual skill, their eagerness, how they work together. It's a lot of different things. So until another team comes around and can challenge them on every single front, will they be toppled, right? Not one thing is going to suddenly make it so they're suddenly number two.
Ding currently collecting their runners-up medal. You can see how drained poor Hulknik is. He was the one saying, you know, I think we can do it. Merry as well, doing outstanding there on artillery. The changes from artillery having a big impact there. He was stunning various vehicles, just picking up kills occasionally. Alien still with a slightly happy smile. He certainly has enjoyed the moment.
I think actually he's the most devastated here. I'm pretty sure he desires this grand final more than anyone.
Positive as well, someone we've seen in the past. And look at this, sheesh. Collecting his medal. I mean, he's been a key factor in Ding's life this season, hasn't he, Mojo?
He is the animal.
Sheesh, coming in to replace Vimpel throughout the season. We saw him do the interviews during the season finals. He's been there as the extra man for Ding, the encouraging moment. And he's been the mem master for him as well.
And the winners, Tornado. Now, Tornado deserved one.
It's the crowd cheering on him. Tornado champ. I think we're going to give a moment of silence for them to lift the trophy and let them kind of, you know, enjoy their moment here.
Some of these guys won already.
Okay, looks like first we're going to do a medal ceremony, then we'll sit back and let Tornado enjoy their trophy moments. That must be so tempting on stage, so teasing on stage to, you know, just, oh, not lift it yet, boys, not lift it yet.
Some of these boys already won the Grand Finals, Grand Final 2 against Na'Vi. Near you, Nesqvi and Diador, you can see them here. This is not their first trophy. On the next Grand Final, they're so close, one game away. And that cursed hill got in the way of Apple.
The smile from Apple over there, holding the gold medal, thinking, hey,
finally,
this is a lot different from the silver one I got last season.
Nuclear, Apple, Wow, Griffon were the guys who played with them in the last Grand Final, and the only person who didn't is Server. First Grand Final, first gold medal.
So this is the player awards, so they get their individual copies of the trophy.
Oh, that looks so cool.
That's so awesome. I wonder how they're going to go and lift the actual main trophy after collecting their individual trophies. They're going to put them down now, or are they just going to have one person lift it?
I'm pretty sure someone can find a way. Diador looks big enough, he can do it like both. One in one hand, other in the other.
They're happy. This is Tornado's moment. 2017 World of Tanks Grand Final Champions. Look at the size of those smiles. Those guys are super happy. Rockstar, your final, well, not your final thoughts. We still got a little time here to kill, but I mean, your thoughts on this tournament as a whole?
Just fantastic World of Tanks all week long. Just the crazy amount of matches from the group stage all the way through. Even the teams that got eliminated first put up some great fights. Teams like Yato surprised us out of nowhere. It was just fantastic World of Tanks all week long.
Awesome moment. Awesome picture of all the teams there on stage, everyone spread out. And there you said, I mean, that was he said, he wanted, you know, this is it, we want to do this for the home fans. You know, we want to take the trophy home. And we were talking during this match, you know, what an upset it would be, you know. Coming to Moscow, first time Grand Finals here in the CIS region. And could have been, as we always say, Mojo, shoulda, woulda, coulda.
The woulda coulda goes for Ding and the rest of the teams, but for these guys it goes just yes way.
It looks like this is going to be their trophy moment, or they're just going to get a picture beside the trophy. Running off here, the the Russian broadcast, obviously everything here for the home crowd. Actually, now that I remember, it is going to be Slava Makarov on stage. He's going to be the one that presents the trophy to the team. I think perhaps it'll be a good moment for us to stay quiet and just enjoy this moment for them to lift the trophy.
Looks really awesome, honestly. Nicely polished, it's gonna make a great paperweight.
Great paperweight. They've got those individual trophies as well, don't they, Rockstar?
Yeah, definitely. Really, well, I said it earlier in the tournament, but I'll say it again. I think it's just so awesome. New trophy every year, redesigned. Just makes it unique every single year, unlike the other sports where they just you recycle the same trophy year after year.
She's lifting it, you can see the, you know, look, he's gone to his face, even bringing it down. It's like solid metal. This is their moment. I mean, they've certainly earned it. What a fantastic season. Perfect way to round off a fantastic season for Tornado Energy in front of a home crowd here. And, well, boy, have they deserved it.